Hey, this is Kev with Blender Binge. In this video, we're gonna build this key using a few of the tools that I've taught in previous videos. So, ready? Here we go. Now, really quickly, all I did to get this in here was I found this online, I saved it as a PNG to my desktop, I dragged it in here inside this orthographic view, and the key picture shows up as an empty. Then, I just turn off selection so I can't stupidly go ahead and select it and ruin the whole video. And then I go to, for the empty here, and I go to the object, where is this? Object data, and I just turned the transparency down so that you could see it better, because that's like glaringly bright, you're not gonna see me do anything. So I turn it to about 50 or whatever, and that's cool. And then I also turn on this little show transparency, or show objects, show whole scene transparent, so you could see through the objects that I'm building. Now, the first thing I do when I go and I try to model something is I look at the shapes. I'm like, what can I get for free? Well, I can get this big circle for free, so that's where I'll probably start. So what I'm gonna do is add mesh, I'll say circle, and I choose vertices at about 50. That gives me enough around that I can start extruding when I need to. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and move this guy up. And I'll hit S to scale them, and scale them a bit, and it's not perfect, and I don't care for this. All right, that's fine, that's good enough. And you'll notice it's not a face, it's just kind of a loop. So what I can do to make it a face is I can hit Tab, you see it selects all this, and hit F for face. Now it's a face. Now what I can do is, now I have my circle, right? I can start going ahead and extruding this. So I need to figure out which edges I want. So I'm gonna go ahead and select some of these edges, and that's probably about good. I'm gonna extrude those down. I'm gonna hit E on the keyboard. I'm gonna hit Enter, because I like to do this with the mouse, and I'm just gonna pull that guy down. All right, so that's pretty good. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to just select these ones. And I'm gonna hit E and do the same thing. All right, click and pull it down. All right, good enough. Now I'm gonna start looking at where I can extrude and where these extrusions will happen. And see, this is like flat and this is raised. So how do I do that? Well, first thing I'll do is I can start moving edges over. So I can start aligning my edges. So I'm gonna say this edge and this edge can move over a little bit. And this edge can move over a little bit. And this edge can move over just a little bit. And I'll try to maintain this nice curvature, but I'm not gonna be too concerned with that. And then I want to cut in and kind of like bring this in too. So what I'll do is I'll hit Control R for loop, cut, and slide. All right, bring that up about here. And I can hit S and scale it in. Being that it's flat, it's just going to scale in nicely. And then I can bring in these guys too. So I can just click and drag them on the Move tool, click and drag and bring that in. And I'm starting to get this shape. And then I want to also, let's see, this edge comes out too far. So let me grab this edge and pull him in to about there. And maybe do the same on this side. All right. And that's probably pretty good for now. And I can go ahead and I can grab these vertices, kind of bring them down. All right. And shape that out. Just like that. And the next thing I can do is I can just start cutting in here for where I want these cuts to be. So to do that, I hit Control R. And I'll say I want one there. Control R, I want one there. Control R, I want one there. And then I probably want one here too. So Control R for there. And I think I can start bringing these in. So Control R here, Control R here, Control R here, And now I can start bringing these guys in. So I can just grab these edges and start bringing those in. Edge here. I can bring this edge in a little bit here. I don't have to worry about making it too symmetrical. It's fine. Maybe I need another one. Control R, get one more in here. Pull this guy down. And there we go. All right, so now we have the shape of key. So now we have to figure out what to extrude. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make an extrusion because there is depth on everything here. So I'm going to go and extrude this, E, enter, and pull it up just a little bit, okay? And that'll give me that nice flat area of the key. All right, so now I need to figure out the parts that stay low versus the parts that stay high, and I need to select the parts that stay high. So to do that, I'm just gonna go into flat, Y, I'm gonna hit A to make sure I deselect everything. I'm gonna hit B, and I'm just gonna select this whole top layer of polygons. And you can see I selected all the top layer there. And now I just need to deselect the parts that I want to stay flat. So those are the cutout key parts, right? So I'm gonna hit Shift, and I'm going to go ahead and get as close as I can to just deselecting the parts that I don't need without selecting anything that I do need. And I'm gonna turn on this box select hole so I don't get those tools in the way. That. So let me go ahead and do this. I'm gonna pause the video and then I'll come back when I'm done. Okay, so now I've just gotten the parts that I want to keep extruding. So I hit E on the keyboard, enter, go to the move tool, and just pull these guys up even further. And now I got a nice, if I turn this off, and I hit tab, you can see here that I've gotten the shape of this key out pretty quickly. All right, that didn't take too long. And now we can go ahead and start punching things in. So I can go ahead and let's see. I have this this piece. So I need to cut this hole in. So what I can do is I can use Boolean. That gets kind of messy. So I'm just gonna use the polygons that already exist here. To do that, I'm gonna hit tab again. I'm gonna select this face and I'm gonna go underneath, hold down shift, oops. Maybe hit B underneath and just select both of those. So I just have those two faces selected and I can go ahead and I can do, let's see, inset faces. Okay. Drag it down. They're nice, they're flat, they're against the top. And then I can just hold G, move it up. Maybe hit S a little bit, bring it out, and then make sure that it's not, see it came up a little bit, so I'm gonna go to the scale tool here and just make it nice and flat against itself. So I go to scale, and I just pull that back down. Make it nice and flat against itself. And then I can extrude that. So I go extrude, E, and click, and then I can scale that down toward itself and just keep going. Don't cross it, but just keep going until it doesn't let you anymore. And then you can hit delete faces, done. I'm not going to worry about connecting that right now. And you can see here that if I turn this off and I hit tab, we have that key shape. And you can go and angle these things in a little bit more. So I'll pause the video and I'll go and like, I'll do one with you here. So I could take this edge over here and maybe this edge, right? And maybe this guy and this guy. And I can pull these guys back a little bit just on the move tool. All right, angle them a bit. So yeah, you can just go ahead and make a bunch of different you know, cuts and things that make it nicer looking. And then when you're done, you can go ahead and add a modifier, a subdivision surface, and then you can do a bevel and put the bevel on top. And now you can start getting a nicer look. And then you can control, you know, the angle, you can control fall off, you can control a bunch of things. And once you put the shader on here, things are going to be different too. So that's about it. I don't want to go too much further with this. I can go into shading this in a further video, but that's kind of how I would go about modeling things. And there's quite a bit more that you can do, but if you want to really just rough out a quick shape, those tools that I showed you here are very, very useful for that. So if you got anything out of this, hit like, subscribe, share, hit that little bell notification, and I will keep going and making more. Thanks. Talk to you later. Bye.